Doppler effect.
Hey, thanks. I'm glad that actually dopplered properly. Proplered.
So now we're going to get Kasoku versus Austin.
This ought to be a treat.
In winner's quarters.
Yeah. So Kasoku's been waiting for a while because he,
was the good grip.
I think he beat Oryx like pretty early, or not
Dang.
Pretty early in the bracket, just like that pretty early in the day.
That is a historically hard matchup for Mario.
Yeah. And he made it work. But this is a lot of people think this is actually a 50-50 matchup.
Yeah.
Because Mario loses a lot of his combo game on like that
on floaties.
Ness, on floaties. And specifically like that big aerial drift that Ness has. Whereas Ness actually can, you know, get a lot of his stuff on Mario because they're about the same height.
That's not going to do it just yet. Not on Mario. Back air? Okay. Use the up B to weave through.
One hallmark of a really good Ness is that they will be able to connect the tail of the PK Thunder to set up for the head.
Yes.
Austin is able to do that so consistently, and it's something that not a lot of people point out about his gameplay, but you can see right there, it's so important because you actually set up to hit them right where you want them to be and perhaps even set up a PK Thunder again, depending on where you hit them.
It also makes it much harder to deal with PK Thunder because if they're attacking you with the head, you don't get, or they're, if they're attacking you with the tail, you can't attack the head to get rid of the hitbox. Mm-hmm. You're just running into the tail.
And you're just not used to it.
Yeah.
Because most Nesses will just go, I make the big thing go hit you. Oh, here it goes. Here it goes, everybody. Here goes Austin with his shenanigans. Oh! That was almost a Zen Yu combo right there. Mm. Which is not something that Kasoku is known for.
Ooh, the back throw. Yeah,
wow,
Kasoku normally known for having the lesser combo game of our Marios, but against Ness, I feel like that's not, you know, going to be as relevant. I feel like his more strong neutral game is really going to play hard.
And presence of mind as well. Kasoku is a
what
fighter.
A good up smash.
Yeah. Yeah, Kasoku's got like a really good mindset when it comes to this game, as far as I can tell.
Oh!
Yeah, Austin bailed out. He was like, okay, he's going to land.
He saw the shield and he was like, all right.
Austin is the best PK Thunder tour in the world, Donat.
Somebody is going to add you with Gakt.
Gakt landed
one.
One?
He landed one.
It's like, yeah, he did it against Anti, but he landed one. There it is again, the tail of the PK Thunder into the PK Thunder head.
That caught the jump.
Yeah.
That was real nice.
Would you call the tail of the PK Thunder PK, like, you know, you have PK Thunder 2. Head of the PK Thunder is PK Thunder 1.
Yeah.
Tail of the PK Thunder, like PK Thunder half or zero?
I have no idea what I would call it.
Okay.
Just call it the tail.
Okay. Game 2 goes to FD, and this will probably make Ness's disadvantage state a little poorer and maybe give Kasoku more chances to follow up. But that also does the same for Austin, unfortunately.
Ooh, did you see the pivot into the up tilt?
Yeah.
Kasoku really working on that combo game.
Working on the combo game.
Look at this.
Importantly, working on the... Just too late with that fireball.
Mm-hmm. Also, too close to matter that he crashed into it.
Yeah.
Yeah, when Ness crashes into stuff with his PK Thunder 2, his distance is significantly shortened. So
I think
from far
I think
away,
it takes away like a third of the distance.
Yeah, it's pretty significant. So sometimes you can even just run out and get hit by it, and as long as you're capable of teching. They'll be too far away.
Oh. Just know that you're taking 26%.
Yeah.
You're like, ask. I'm going to get Falcon Punched, but I might kill them.
Yeah. Is it worth it?
Kasoku
has such a solid control right now.
Yeah.
Austin edged his way in with the Nair, but Kasoku took stage control right back. He's got to land, though.
Okay.
Ooh, the back air pushes Austin off stage.
Okay, great air dodge through the flood. Back air is going to give him really good stage position. And that time, Kasoku able to air dodge out. Austin took just a little bit too much time to hit him with the head.
That's
and
it.
Back throw should do it.
That was a little bit of spaghetti on that last interaction there.
All right. Kasoku landing back air to up smash. Now off stage again. Let's see how he... Okay, so I like that he didn't use his double jump, but not going to matter. Austin able to connect that PK Thunder to upper, which is kind of like one of his bread and butters.
Yeah, same setup yet again. There we go. Tried to go for the fair, but didn't beat out the Mario Nair.
Okay. Shielding that up air. Hisoka's also gotten very good at perfect shielding. His defense has gotten a lot better. But Austin just with a barrage of the same two moves over and over.
Bullying him with those buttons. But Mario's got some buttons to fight back. He's not somebody to get frame bullied.
Yeah.
He can fight back with that nair. And he can space you out with that back air of his own.
Okay, interesting.
Definitely not
stall.
A slow move. Definitely got some decent recovery on it, you know.
Sunku, by
catches
the way,
the roll.
Got hit out of his forward smash when Austin naired him there. Mm-hmm. Again!
Air dodge that time because Austin had been going for immediate attacks to cover the jump, to cover the nothing.
Speaking of immediate, just almost immediately going for that PK Thunder.
Waits for the air dodge, and that's a game for Kisoku.
Yeah. Kisoku's playing real solid today. Woo-ha! Mario sounds a little bit like Majima.
A little bit.
Woo-ha!
Oh, God. I can just imagine him pulling out, like, a sword.
Yeah. Oi! Luigi-chan.
Why is that so good?
I don't know.
What if you went into... What if you went into the credits for Yakuza and you were like, wait, Charles Martin voices Majima?
What? Anyway, I think we're getting close to the credits of this game because Austin is running through Kisoku right now.
Yeah, Austin loves this stage. And while it can be good for Mario, it's not against floaties. And Austin is demonstrating just how so. Also, because he was PK thundering, the fireball bounced over.
Yeah, Mario's ladder is also, I feel like, much weaker as a... As an option than it is for like someone like Bayo or someone like ZSS. Their ladders are so much more potent.
Yeah. It takes like some really specific setups to get your opponent on that top platform. Mm. Oh, Austin going right in, dude.
Okay, gets that nair, punishes, and now lapped Kisoku in percent. Austin playing mad.
This man's not joking. But here we go.
Catches the DI up so he can't do anything about it.
He almost got the good hits there on the up B, but unfortunately not going to be able to take him off the top just yet without that rage.
Kisoku tried to dunk him right there, but move a little bit too slow. The fair is fighting his way back, and now Kisoku off stage has to recover.
Austin.
Good tech. No, but he got footstooled.
Wow.
Okay. I love that Kisoku actually went out there, though, because after the wall bounce, Austin would have been able to go for another PK Thunder.
Yeah. And Austin is the kind of guy that will successfully execute such a feat.
Yeah. Back in the day when Duck Hunt was legal. All the time.
Yeah. Oh, I don't want to think about Duck Hunt being legal anymore. I used to
Austin's
like that
favorite stage.
I used to like that stage, and then I played
Same.
Karna on it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And I stopped liking it after that.
He's
living.
Alive.
Wow, that is like the maximum percent he probably could have lived.
Rage Mario is pretty terrifying, but he can't get grabbed and he can't get aerial.
Well... Okay. It is staled.
Across stage.
Now he can't get grabbed.
Yeah. That was a really good jump air dodge.
Ooh, just missing that grab, Nair.
At this point, Austin can just throw out those hitboxes. He can take any trade he needs to, because almost anyone is going to lead him to the kill.
Yeah.
And Austin was eventually able to seal that one out.
Yep. So moving on to winner semis is Austin.
That was a really, really good game two from Kisoku, and game one was really solid too, but game three, Austin just turned up the jets.
Yeah. He said...